استهداف عام شبابها.
Analysts call these elections crucial, with the ruling United Russia Party aiming to maintain its overwhelming majority in the State Duma, the Russian parliament. The poll follows months of pressure against the liberal and democratic opposition in the streets, and against independent media on the internet, something that has political activists deeply pessimistic.
It's even debatable if we can speak about the opposition in Russia. You know, opposition is a term that's associated with democracies. Oppositions usually sit in parliaments or in television studios, can participate in elections. In our country today, the key opponents of this regime are either dead, imprisoned, or exiled.
Popular support for Putin remains notably high, with a Levada Center survey finding he has a 65% approval rating. The political struggle for seats in parliament is between Putin's party and the communists or nationalist radicals, parties that many independent observers say are considered systemic or a facade to maintain the democratic image of the country.
We have got currently both communists, LDPR and Fair Russia in the Duma. Has Duma become a venue for discussions? No, for a long time. No, for already several sessions.
Despite the pressure against candidates who are critical of the government, the only hope for the opposition is with the liberal parties, such as Yabloko, the Russian Democratic Party, and some independent candidates who have managed to participate in these elections.
The only positive thing about elections is campaigning, because no matter how they count, and even no matter how we vote, because it doesn't count, and the important thing is that you at least can speak up.
Concerns about possible fraud are widespread. The opposition hopes for a massive turnout as the best defense against any attempts to rig the vote.
If they try to do that, the legitimacy of the Duma will be equal to zero. That is why it is required to mobilize our supporters, despite everything.
But early indications point to a low voter turnout. With few opposition candidates running and voter apathy generally high, big political changes in Russia appear to be unlikely this time around. For Ricardo Marquina in Moscow, John Spier, VOA News.